All right, so you should have Balsamiq downloaded to your Mac or PC now and installed, and you can launch the tool and we can get started on your wireframes. So first we want to go over some key concepts. You'll open a new project when you launch the tool, and we'll take a look around in a moment, but first I just want to remind you of this idea that we introduced in the intro about failing fast, because the tool is really optimized around this idea of adding these rough controls to your wireframe as fast as you think through the problem. And the idea is not to be fussy, but just to get things out there really quickly, to come up with each idea as you go, and you know, come up with variations and new ideas so that you're exploring all the possibilities. So with that in mind, let's take a look around the tool, and you'll see that there is a toolbar across the top. There's a ribbon across the middle with our UI library, and there are two panels on the sides. On the left is our project browser. On the right is our inspector panel, and in the big area in the middle, the white area, is your canvas where you're going to be adding controls. Let's go up to this toolbar, and you'll see in the upper left there is a title area. If you double click that, you can rename the project. So we'll just say Skillshare demo for this one. And then that should be the basis for the project when you save it. So we're going to save. It's a good idea to save the project right away once you know what the name is, because you'll have this autosave going in the background as you work. So we save this, and you see the title for the project shows up in the title bar. Now, the icons in the upper left have different views you can switch between. So this little menu here will switch between the mockups, which is the main view you're going to be using. That shows this left panel with thumbnails of the wireframe that you're on. The assets view will show you your images, any custom icons you might add, or files even, binary files like PDFs or design comps can be put in here. The symbols panel is where you're going to find your reusable symbols libraries. Trash will show the mockups you might have deleted, so you can restore them in the future in case you didn't really want to lose them. The icons here for the navigator can toggle the left navigator on or off. And the grid view will just give you an overview of the thumbnails in your project. So the plus icon is what we use to create new mockups. I click to the plus here, and you see a new mockup appearing in the project browser. If I deleted this one now by selecting Move to Trash from that context menu, it shows up in the trash, and you can go to restore it or delete it permanently. The middle of our toolbar has some edit icons that we'll cover later. There is an input for quick add, which we'll also cover. This icon here will toggle the UI library ribbon on and off. That's the big ribbon across the middle. And the eye inspector up here switches between our mockup inspector or our control inspector. So you added a control here, and you can see the properties for this button. You can toggle that, both of these things off. So if we hide them there, you'll have more space. And the last panel here on the right is our project information. Selecting that will let you add notes about your project. You can also switch between the sketchy rough skin and the more polished wireframe skin. And this affects all the wireframes in your project. There's also a default font that you can select for the project, font size, as well as the link color and the selection color. Okay, and the last icon on the right is for full screen presentation mode, and we'll get to that towards the end of the course. This just shows a full screen view of your mockup without any of the tools in the interface. So now I'm going to show you a few different ways of building up a wireframe. We're going to use the UI library first. And if we have the UI library in view, you'll see a button bar at the top that has categories of controls. Selecting one of them will filter that set down. So we're going to select forms and build a login form for this example. So you can just scroll through the controls here and double click a control once you find it. So we're going to add a field set. We get a text input, a couple text inputs as well, just by double clicking those. You can also just drag things right from the UI library. So here's a button I'm going to drag in and then position. And if I select all these controls that I placed and right click here, you'll see options for aligning and distributing. So I'm going to align everything left and then space them out vertically. And now I'm going to just hold shift or command to deselect one of these controls, the button, and then I'm going to resize the inputs. And that's how you use the UI library to build up a wireframe. So now we're going to hide the UI library. Let's also hide the project information on the right panel and hide the navigator. So this is a more of a focused view here. And we're going to switch to using Quick Add to build up this form. So if you select slash or click the Quick Add input in the upper right to put that in focus, you can start typing to look for controls and add them to your canvas. So let's start with the typing field set here, or the first few letters, and then we'll get the text input. We'll add that a couple times. And then lastly, we'll add a button. So it's a little bit faster if you're the type of person who likes to type rather than to visually go through the UI library. We'll do the same thing with our right click here to space these things out vertically. And then we can also do that from this alignment menu in the toolbar. If I command click here again, I can resize just the two inputs. And there you go, there's our login form built just using the Quick Add control. You'll also notice if I move things around that these little smart alignment guides will show up, and that should make it easier for you to snap things in place without really having to think about being too precise. But it'll help you so that you can get some, you know, alignment worked out. All right, so last thing we have is this quick draw mode. So if I hold the R key there while clicking and dragging, what's going to happen is that we're drawing rectangles. So this is a great way to just sort of quickly lay out parts of a UI. And all you're doing is putting placeholders. So I'm putting in two inputs and a button here by using these boxes. So it's a bit like sketching something out on paper. There are a few other modes for a quick draw, but the basic idea is that you just draw rectangles. Then you select a control, and then you type Control T or Command T on a Mac to open up this transform dialog. What I just did there was I converted the rectangle to a field set. I'm going to do this for each of these boxes. Here's going to be converted to a text input. And lastly, I converted the last box into a button. Last thing you can do here is you can marquee select a bunch of controls that we place here. So I'm going to just hold down the shift key and then click and drag to select all the controls here. And then from the menu, I can select Edit Group, or you can use the keyboard shortcut Control G or Command G to group that set of controls. This way you can bind all these controls together into one group and then move them around as one piece. If you open up the inspector, you'll notice the group now is what's being shown here in the properties inspector. And there is a property called name, and this is one way to use this group is to convert it into a reusable symbol. So once I have this login here, I can, you know, give it a name and login. And if I do a quick add search for a login, now that's going to show up as one of my controls. If I select the UI library and then select symbols, you'll see that the login is also in our symbols category now. All right, so that covers our key concepts for using Balsamiq mockups. And the next thing we're going to get to is really starting to design our project. And we're going to talk about the initial stages when you're really kind of working on a sketch, and then get deeper into detailed wireframing after that. So we'll see you in the next section.